Okay, so next area is, I believe, inside the refinery. Okay. Inside this vent here. So we gotta go to an area where we can shut off the power to those fans that keep spinning. We missed it right here somewhere. There it is. Okay, we can't go through there. There it is. Alright, the fans are down and the power should be shut off over here too.
Is that mission?
I got them both. I got them both. I got them. Yo, why take so many tail whips? Shit, dude. Damn, in campaign they got way more health. Like in multiplayer, two tail whips, but we just killed them. Oh, wrong way. Wait. Yeah, this way. There we go. So the order of the storyline that you should play is Alien first, Marine second, and then Predator last. Because the aliens basically escape and cause all that havoc. Marines are called in to try to save everyone out and get all the survivors. And then the Predators are left in the end. They basically just beat up everything else. So the thing with the alien mission is you don't really have to kill everyone.
Did you hear that?
Where am I going? I'm kind of confused already. Shit. I'm confused, man. I don't even know if I'm going the right way anymore. Okay, I am. Alright.
It's here! It's here!
There we go. They're dead. You know, one thing the fans actually wanted in this game was the female characters in multiplayer, but that never really happened. You know, it's really dark. Let me increase my brightness. It's really dark. There we go. Now we can actually see shit. Fuck. Oh, man. That was pretty rough. I mean, you do have the option of going to kill all the Marines you want, if you wanted, but you don't really need to. Because the alien mission is like the stealth mission out of all three. The Marine mission is like kill everything. And the Predator mission is a mix of both. I mean, you can go stealth and you can go, you know, killing everything. It's whatever you want. Oh, this guy. He was walking backwards. Oh, jeez. He was walking backwards. And throughout the campaign, you're actually going to run to some civilians that you can just impregnate right away with facehuggers. Alright, here we kill everything.
It ain't over.
What was that?
Oh my god, dude, die! Like, what the fuck? Yo. I got so much health.
We've lost contact with a Marine.
Oh, you've lost contact with like many Marines already. Since the beginning, man. Since the beginning. Get the stupid jelly container. I don't even know why you can pick it up. I mean, I have everything already.
Was that movement?
I can destroy those lights. That one too. Alright. I guess I should have done that a long time ago, but whatever, man. Wow, yo, he took so many tail whips. Where are you going? Oh! Shit, motherfucker. Holy crap. You could have killed me, man. You could have killed me. What the? That. Okay. Oh my gosh, she blocked my shot. I'm on the floor. Shit. Okay, where are you? Yeah, controlling the alien is a little tricky. Oh my god, as you can see, I am still not used to it after all these years. Fuck. Oh man. Now, the reason the alien is a little bit hard to control is because when you have wall walk abilities and you're like running around the map really fast, you're gonna eventually run over these little boxes and little containers and stuff and shells, and that just really throws you off. And sure, it's a lot. Get out of here. And here's a civilian I can impregnate with a face hugger. Alright, that's done. So now we can escape over here, and that should be it. So up next, we got some matches in Street Fighter 3 Third Strike Online Edition on Xbox 360. So click one of the links on the right side of this page and enjoy.